Happy Friday, everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use non-destructive testing for evaluation of cracks in a concrete beam element. But first, let's see what a crack is. A crack is a linear fracture in concrete which extends partly or completely through the member. Concrete is a relatively good material in compression. However, it can easily break as a result of tensile stresses. Several issues can result in cracks in concrete, including excessive external loads, external restraint forces, internal restraint forces, differential movements, settlements, or corrosion of steel reinforcement. In a concrete beam, tensile stresses are initially carried by the concrete and reinforcement. When the tensile stress in the beam exceeds the tensile capacity, the concrete cracks. After this point, the tensile force is transferred completely to the steel reinforcement. In a concrete beam, the crack widths and their distribution is mainly controlled by transverse reinforcement, or simply the stirrups. Cracks resulting from externally applied loads initially appear as hairline cracks and are harmless. However, as the reinforcement is further stressed, the initial cracks open up and progressively spread into numerous wider cracks. Now that we know why and how concrete cracks, let's get back to our first question. How can we evaluate cracking in concrete? A systematic assessment often starts with detailed close-up visual inspection of the element. The cracks and other surface defects are identified and marked. For each crack, two pieces of information are collected: the crack width and the crack depth. Crack depths can provide an indication of the severity of the cracks. Crack widths can easily be measured using a simple crack ruler. Modern applications using image processing techniques or laser scans can also be used to study the distribution and width of the cracks. While hairline cracks might not impose serious risk on the structural integrity, wider cracks can be a sign of severe distress and require immediate attention, repair, and retrofitting. Crack depths, on the other hand, can be used to study the structural integrity and durability performance of a concrete beam. One simple NDT method for estimating the crack width is the ultrasonic pulse velocity, or simply UPV. In this particular application, the sending transducer is placed on one side of the crack, while the receiving transducer is placed on the other side. First, the sensors are placed at a distance D, and the transit time between the two sensors are measured. Later, the distance is increased to double D, and the test is repeated. Then the results are used to estimate the crack depth. Crack depth can show if the surface defects propagate deep in the concrete element or are just limited to the surface, thus helping engineers in evaluating structural integrity. Another great technology is the ground penetrating radar, or simply GPR. We use GPR scans to locate the stirrups. This will allow structural engineers to verify the adequacy of existing reinforcement for the intended loading. It will also provide information on the structural details, such as rebar spacing and concrete cover thickness. How about concrete thickness in elements with one side access only? Examples can be the beam I showed you earlier, retaining walls, or the walls in a concrete tank. Ultrasonic pulse echo can be used to evaluate the thickness of existing elements. The method uses shear waves to estimate the depth and location of internal voids and anomalies, as well as the thickness of the concrete element. Last but not least is the rebound hammer test. Rebound hammer or Schmidt hammer can be used to identify weak spots in a concrete element. It can also be used to get an estimate of the compressive strength if a reliable correlation between the compression test and rebound number is established. Another great approach is the use of combined NDT methods such as Son-Reb. This procedure allows for a more reliable and accurate estimate of concrete strength on the spot. This helps minimize the number of intrusive tests and avoid unnecessary intervention. Several researchers have developed mathematical models to determine the compressive strength by combining the ultrasonic pulse velocity and rebound hammer number in an exponential function. To wrap up what we discussed today, visual inspection is the first step towards evaluating the condition of concrete beams. Crack width rulers can be used to identify the severity of cracks, while UPV method can help engineers in evaluating the crack depths. GPR can be used to determine the location and spacing of stirrups, and also to get an estimate of concrete cover thickness. Ultrasonic Pulse Echo, on the other hand, can provide critical information on the thickness of concrete elements as well as identifying potential subsurface defects. And finally, Rebound Hammer Test can be used to verify the uniformity of concrete and also to get an estimate on concrete strength in the element. Thank you very much for your attention and have a lovely weekend. Stay safe.